All right, so we get the cold open here for the ECW show.
The voiceover.
Paul Heyman gives a little bit of voiceover action.
Yes.
Yeah, he's straight off his roller jam job, and he said, I guess I'll also do this.
Yeah, I might as well. I already got the footage. I might as well keep going here. He puts over Raven big here. He says, in 1996, the poet of the macabre ruled ECW as the heavyweight champion. I was like, oh, my God, wow.
Yeah, it's actually funny. Because we were watching stuff in Chicago. We just basically had ECW on TV the whole time.
Yeah.
And in like 96, Paul Heyman was like, he would have been like, Raven in 96 was the poet of macabre. And so he's like, yeah, so Raven in 96 was the poet of macabre.
Yeah, pretty much.
So Paul Heyman goes over Raven's feuds from Tommy Dreamer to Sandman. Of course, the infamous angle where Raven recruited Sandman's ex-wife, Peaches, and yes. his little kid, Tyler. And Tyler, of course, saying the infamous line, Daddy, you're a drunk. I worship a Raven now.
That's so sick. He worships me.
That's the best ever. Oh.
That's so sick.
So Raven is now the tag champs with Tommy Dreamer, but the hatred between Sandman and Raven is tearing them all apart.
Oh my gosh.
Tonight, Raven will face Sandman with Tommy Dreamer as the referee.
That's a pretty big ECW match, really.
Yeah, you're right, Raven. But it's funny because I think every single week was some form of Tommy, Raven, and Sandman and
sure,
some sort of
yeah,
six
really
man
was,
or face
yeah.
each other or something. That was the ECW six, yeah. Yeah.
And this match is also actually Sandman's first ECW match back from WCW.
You're right. I was reading a little bit about that.
After Raven tricked him to go over there.
Conned me.
Steve Corino will also confront Fred Durst tonight.
Big deal. He's
for
had
Fred?
Yeah, which is awesome. I love that. That angle through the whole show is tremendous.
Yeah, it is. Steve's a really good character.
Yeah,
he is.
So we get the opening for ECW here.
So long.
It is so long. It's a whole
so
music video.
If Suzuki was on this show, he would have no song at all. There's no time for it.
I do love the opening with like, Extreme Championship.
Wrestling.
Yeah, I pop for it every time. I like it a lot.
And there's a lot of sweet clips in it too, and they eventually add the Fred Durst clip to it as well.
Oh, that's cool, yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, just it's like 3 minutes long. Like it's the whole song.
Yeah.
Fuck.
It is the whole song, exactly. Yeah. So we have the ECW on TNN opening with Joel Gertner and Joey Styles in the ring. This is usually how they open their shows up here.
This is at the ECW Arena in Philadelphia. There's a couple fun signs here. One of them, honk if you're Irish. You're spelled wrong. He has dandruff with an arrow pointing down.
This guy actually had like 3 or 4 signs.
Yeah, was it all the same guy?
Yeah, it was all the same guy.
Those are the two I remember.
Oh, there's another one that you missed. I can't believe you didn't get this.
There's
one
for Just Incredible later that I liked, but
there was one that said Ike Turner Fan Club.
How great.
Oh, yeah. He also had a sign that said Limp Bizkit Fears Karina. It was a double sign with his buddy beside him, and they held it up. And it went
That's awesome. Yeah.
Double signs. Yeah. I love it.
That's
yeah.
tremendous.
So Joel Gertner grabs the microphone from Joey Styles as he has to do his intro. Yeah. Joel Gertner says, I am Joel. I make him holler for a dollar and do some strange for some change.
The quintessential stunt muffin, Joel. I make them holler for a dollar and do something strange for some change.
Gertner. And Joey's just sitting there shaking his head the whole time.
Yeah. Joey, every week I gotta do this shit.
Yeah. I'm surprised he never ran out of things to say. So
he always had new bits, man.
Yeah, absolutely. So the Impact players come out. Joey Styles tries to announce them, but I'm guessing the dub music just
it was
drowned
dub
out.
Dub music, and yeah, it was brutal. There's also someone immediately puts up a Jerichoholics Anonymous sign with a phone number.
Just call him to hit him up.
Help. There's once Just Incredible comes out here, someone holds up a sign that says, you're still Aldo.
That's fucked.
Of course, Aldo Montoya.
So the Impact players come out. For people who do not know, the Impact players are Just Incredible, Lance Storm, Jason Knight, and Dawn Marie.
Jason, the sexiest
man. You put
man
some
alive,
more
right?
respect on Jason's name. That is the world's sexiest man, Jason.
The world's sexiest man, that's what it was.
His famous pose of sitting there with his arms crossed.
Yeah, it's so much. What the fuck?
I would also like to give a very big shout out to Dawn Marie for being Dawn Marie.
Was she just Dawn Marie, or was she Dawn Marie bitch here to coincide with Sonny being Tammy Lynn Sitch?
You know what? They were feuding at the time.
Yeah.
So I'm not entirely sure, but Dawn Marie works for me here.
I agree. Yeah, but shouts out expeditiously.
That's true. Justin Gredible says Joey is talking to the tag team champs, and Joey said, "I'm going to let you try that one more time." Joey says, Justin is jumping the gun here because they're not the tag team champs. Oh. That would be Raven and Tommy Dreamer right now.
Yes.
And Justin says, well, that's why there are guys like Rhino and Candido to take the bullet for him.
Ooh.
And guess who comes out?
Rhino and Candido.
You damn right. But guess who comes
Sonny.
Out?
And yeah. Sonny Tony.
Tony, you got any thoughts?
Tony. What are you thinking there?
Whatever Justin Credible did with his kendo, that's what I was thinking.
Dude, he just started
He did my gimmick. He did my gimmick with the taking liberties. That's sick.
Just started jerking off the cane directly at her. I was like, all
and
right,
Sonny
Drew.
Just immediately grabs it. I was like, okay. That's true. Candido says that he carried Lance Storm, and the only reason Justin is here is because he brought him here.
Yeah, it was. Candido said, I carried your stupid Canadian ass for over a year. And then he goes like, he's hyping it up like he's going to say something crazy about Justin Credible. Don't edit me. Don't take this off the show, Paul. The only reason you're here, Justin, is because I brought you here. What?
And don't cut me off and don't edit me. The only reason you're here is because I brought your ass here.
The fuck? Okay.
And Rhino then chimes in with, yeah, enough of the talk. Let's just kick their fucking asses.
Let's kick their fucking ass. And then gores the world's sexiest man, Jason.
What the fuck? He's just standing there with his arms crossed. He's just chilling. Why you do that?
Damn it. Bastard.
Everyone starts brawling. It's actually broken up pretty quick. Crowd starts booing. Then
Sonny and
Don Marie
do the
start
cat fight.
Fighting.
Cat fight! Cat fight! Bloodshot!
The cat fight thing is probably my favorite commentary thing here. My favorite trigger.
Yeah, it's really good.
Yeah. Must have been cold in that arena, too.
Yeah, well, you know, it always is when Sonny comes out,
it seems. Of course. It was cold.
So we go backstage. Jack Victory is talking to Steve Corino.
What's wrong, bro?
Steve Corino says, I cannot concentrate with all this damn music next door.
There's a very loud concert going on next door.
With 16,000 people. Incorrect.
Bullshit.
The Limp Bizkit concert is too loud, and Corino has an important match that he needs to get ready for.
Yeah.
What match? Where's the match?
Who knows what the match? I don't know what the match was meant to be. It never happens because he was so distracted. He said, Rhino's not paying attention to me. Tajiri lost at the pay-per-view. I don't know if I'm doing something wrong. I don't know if I'm doing something right. What?
This is all Fred Durst's fault.
But I'm going to go over there and tell everyone at that stupid concert what Steve Corino is all about. And then he's walking away. He's like, you coming with me, Jack? And he's like, oh, you're just like Rhino and Tajiri. He says, I hate Limp Bizkit and I hate stupid rock and roll.
Are you with me or not? Fine, be that way. Just like Rhino. I'm going to show him, Jack. I hate Limp Bizkit. I hate stupid rock and roll.
I also hate rock and roll.
Yeah, me too.
So, we get Super Crazy versus Ikuto Hidaka.
Dude, what the fuck? This match rules.
Yeah, so Super Crazy. I've told you guys a story before. Super Crazy, one of my favorite guys growing up.
Yes.
Super Crazy is the coolest wrestling name ever.
The Insane Luchador, your favorite?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah, I mean, like, that's the shit.
My name is Super Crazy. Hell yeah,
yeah,
like, it is.
That is the crazy song.
Yeah, he starts wrestling, he starts doing a bunch of bullshit. I'm like, wow, this is awesome.
Yeah, he does his entrance here, moonsaults into the ring, and kicks the microphone out of the ring announcer's hand mid-moonsault.
He doesn't even care. He just backs up off on
whatever.
Whatever.
Fuck
yeah,
it.
Don't get my way next time. So Hidaka is from Battle Arts, which was a promotion in Japan that was kind of based around shoot wrestling.
Yes.
I actually don't think it runs anymore.
Okay.
But Hidaka still wrestles today. Actually, Super Crazy and Hidaka still wrestle.
I think Funaki trained him, too.
Yeah, these guys are incredible. Like, this is a really fun, like, TV match here.
Well, don't forget about Sandman here that they had to throw in randomly
right
the entrances.
Middle, yeah.
Super Crazy does his entrance, and then, all right, we're going backstage. They don't even tell us. It just cuts to the Sandman. Sandman says, you took my wife, you took my child, and worst of all, you conned me into leaving ECW.
You made me go to that shitty WCW. I fucking hate WCW.
You played.
You took my wife. You took my child. You even conned me into leaving ECW. Tonight, I'm going to take you, Raven, to the extreme.
They made me be hack over there and wear a polo.
What a mark.
Tonight, yeah. All non-canon in my eyes. Tonight, I'm going to take you, Raven, to the extreme. And he burns a cigarette out in his hand. That's pretty extreme.
Yeah, just randomly right in the middle of this super crazy document.
Yeah, okay.
Just,
yeah, like, what the
fuck? This is Sandman, by the way.
Hey, how's it going?
Yo. Joe Gertner was crazy in this match. Like, this dude will not stop.
The whole match, he will not stop referring to Pokemon.
Just can't stop. These guys are having a really solid killer match.
Yeah,
and he just cannot stop.
Just trying to do
Pokemon
bits.
References.
Just fuck.
Very Mark Madden-esque, actually. Is a really good way to put it.
Terrible.
Yeah. Near the end, though, I think he just gives up because the match is too sweet for
it's
him.
It's too
even
sweet.
Meme
yeah, you yeah. can't stop. Like, you can't. You got to stop doing that shit.
This match is like really good. Like, it blew me away how like much shit they did in this and how much Hidaka got in this one, too.
Yeah, I was, you know what? Because Super Crazy sort of. He's been in ECW for a minute at this point.
Sure, he's a mainstay.
And Hidaka is coming in doing his thing. So Hidaka and Crazy, very first thing we really get into here is the sweep the leg, arm drag, kip up thing, you know, like that Super Crazy did that a lot.
Arvidy Lynn
It's like an ECW spot when you, it's kind of to establish that these kind of guys are fast.
Equal.
And it's a good thing to do.
Sure.
Hidaka does a handspring spinning heel kick in the corner.
Okay,
because
I didn't know how to describe that. Yeah.
That's the best way I could describe it. I don't really know. That's probably the best way to do it. Hidaka then brings the guardrail in and does like a springboard whisper in the wind to the outside, which was
like
fucked.
He like baseball slides Super Crazy over the guardrail and then like, yeah, acai flip. Like that. Yes. Crazy,
right? Crowd went crazy.
Over the rail. Yeah, it's fucking nuts.
We get back in. Hidaka then hits a springboard tornado DDT on Super Crazy,
like,
which looked
not,
really good.
And not like springboard like from the apron over the rope, like it was like spring back, turned around, tornado DDT, like
it was crazy. Super Crazy is a really good base here, like he is really giving him a lot. It's really nice. Super Crazy cuts him off with a power bomb and then hits a moonsault off the second rope, which just looked great.
Power bombs him to hell out of Arana, and then he does like a weird like inside out moonsault. I don't know how to
he steps out of the rope.
Oh my god,
yeah, like
he steps away from the turnbuckle. Yeah, it's kind of cool. It's a really cool move.
It's awesome.
Super Crazy does a 10 punch in the corner, and the crowd counts in Spanish, which was cool.
I love
that.
That
was awesome. Yeah.
And then they wanted him to do it again. They said, uno más. And then he does 10
he said,
more.
Okay. Hidaka then does a cartwheel that jumps into the shoulders of Super Crazy and then hits a spike Rana for a two.
What the fuck, dude? Like, and then right after that, he hits a crazy bridge German for a two
dude,
as well.
He releases it, but then holds on at the same time.
I thought it was a release, and then he had the grip. I was like,
and he still has the pin. It was so fucking crazy.
It's unbelievable.
Though.
Dude, it was beautiful. It's a really good bridge, too. And
Super Safe, it was awesome.
It was insane,
Hidaka then goes for a tornado DDT in the corner. Super Crazy ends up just throwing him out to the middle of the ring.
Yeah,
and Super Crazy hits the biggest die bomb I've ever seen.
Oh,
power bombs him to shit.
Hidaka hits the mat 5 seconds before Crazy does.
It's a sit-out power bomb, though.
It's crazy.
Oh. They hit the moonsault off the rope and
top
ends
rope
up the
Luther
win.
Salt. It wasn't like moonsault from the top rope. It was in the middle.
Like a
lion
springboard.
Salt style, except
top
rope. Yeah.
Good shit, man. They're just fantastic match.
What a
really
killer opener, man.
Yeah, you really couldn't have asked for better from these two. Like, I don't know if these guys ever ran it at a pay-per-view, but they fucking could have.
Yeah, they could have. Yeah.
I don't know how you don't bring Hidaka back after that. I'm going to check, actually, to see what other ECW stuff he did.
For sure.
So Hidaka's first ECW TV appearance is that match against Crazy. He loses.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Then he does some house shows for them for a bit, kind of working the same matches. Then his next time on TV, he faces Super Kello and Tom Marquez, and it goes to a no contest. I don't know what happened there.
They were in Richmond, Virginia. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. And then he just kind of, he does a couple more house shows, and then he faces Super Crazy on TV one more time in Nashville.
Longer match.
Yeah, 8 minutes on ECW on TNN number 18. The first one was number 15. So it's like three episodes later they run it back.
I'm going to check it out.
Yeah, I actually might. Yeah. Maybe we should watch that for Watch This.
There's actually only two matches on that ECW on TNN show. So there's Super Crazy versus Hidaka, and then there's Mike Awesome versus Masato Tanaka.
Oh, wow. Did that's for the title, that? Too.
Yeah, for the title.
Did we watch that one? I swear I put that one on one time and watched it.
Maybe. When we were away? Maybe. Yeah.
I think I skipped just to the Mike Awesome match.
Yeah,
so
we'll have to figure out something. Maybe we'll figure out something with that. Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. So we go backstage here on ECW on TNN. Steve Corino is now at the Limp Bizkit concert. He's like right at the door. He said he's going to prove that Steve Corino is a force to be reckoned with in ECW.
He said, I'm not a comedy act, and I brought you, the cameraman, to the Limp Bizkit concert.
I bet you felt really good about that. He was like, oh, fuck yeah. It's awesome. Yeah, Limp Bizkit 99 was fucking insane.
Hell yeah, bro. Crazy. They had 16,000 people, right?
Yeah, 25,000 from what I've just been told in my headset.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So we get a backstage segment. Cyrus, the vice president of ECW Canada, of course.
I don't remember that being a thing.
Cyrus tonight is going to ask Jerry Lynn if he is in cahoots with Tajiri.
I guess we can say, because people might not know, Cyrus is Don Callis.
You know what? That's a good call. Yeah.
Yeah. He's also a carny piece of shit.
Yeah. Carny piece of shit, Cyrus, the vice president of ECW Canada.
Yeah. For those of you that may not know.
Now we go to the Limp Bizkit concert. Steve Corino is now in the crowd of the Limp Bizkit concert. I actually love the way they filmed all this shit.
I love this, actually. Yeah. Because I was like, damn, is this the spot? But I was like, no, there's more to come still. Yeah. This is fucking hilarious, actually.
So Steve starts asking a girl. Just
random girl. Yeah.
If she has any respect for herself.
She's like trying to walk to go to like the bathroom or something. And he gets in her face. Do you have any respect for yourself? And she's like very confused, trying to continue to walk away. And then he keeps yelling at her. He says, you guys, you participating in drug abuse and premarital sex and
her
devil
face
worship
is hilarious.
And music? She's shocked and confused.
My favorite part of this is right after that. It's like as the segment is cutting away, Steve looks up and sees people grinding on a stage above him.
What is this?
What is this?
This is disgusting.
It like pans. It was like the perfect shot. It pans over the grinding.
Like an
people,
accident.
Pans back at Steve. What is this?
It felt like an accident. Yeah, it was tremendous.
So we go backstage. A very stark difference between the Limp Bizkit concert and Raven sitting in his corner.
Yeah, Raven.
Raven's we go backstage. Raven.
Yeah. This is actually a really good promo here.
Yeah.
Raven talks about Sandman. He says Sandman is an abusive drunk, just like his father is.
Just like my father.
He says his father used to come home from work and just beat the crap out of him. Raven said his father failed at everything in his life. He lost his wife. He lost his kid. Hey, Sandman, didn't you lose your wife and kid, too?
Oh, I thought that was such a killer line, man.
That was like
so
a shitty little laugh.
He said, he said, my father was an abusive drunk, just like you, Sandman, and the only reason I didn't kill that son of a bitch is because that bastard died before I could figure out how to do it and get away with it.
Wow, that's brutal.
No Google back then to look
it
up.
He said, it was awesome. He said, Sandman, you're not dead yet, but you're going to wish you were. Quote the Raven, nevermore. I was like, oh my God.
God
so
damn.
Good.
That was
so
just an ECW on TNN promo for him. That was just like every week for him.
Like it was just like, I don't know how many people remember that fucking promo. I was like, oh my, there's just, every line is killer in this.
Yeah.
So we go to a Limp Bizkit concert again. Steve Corino has now found himself on stage at the Limp Bizkit concert.
How did he get up there?
In his singlet. Is at the concert
his
singlet.
He's got to get ready. He's ready for his match.
His match. Where's his match?
He's got to have his fucking match. And there's
I guess
girl.
He can after what happens.
Of course. No, it get canceled. He had to go to the hospital. Limp Bizkit, Fred Durst has a girl up there. He gets on the mic and says, get the fuck off the stage. Corino says, that's real nice, lady. You talk to your mother with that foul mouth? And then the girl just pulls her pants down and moons him. What the fuck?
That's awesome.
She just shows her ass. Here's my asshole.
I'm pretty sure Fred just said, hey, dude, shut the fuck up.
Yeah, he does. He says, shut the fuck up. And Cora says, hey, you shut up for a second.
And then when Steve goes, yeah, well, everybody knows, wants to know. Everybody needs to go watch ECW on TNA to watch Steve Corino.
Every Friday on the Nashville Network.
Yeah, he goes, if you don't know, my name is the king of old school, Steve Corino.
He cuts a whole ass promo randomly in the middle of the segment.
And then Fred Durst says, yeah.
Fred Durst just like bleep, 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 bleep.
This guy looks like a bleep, bleeper, bleep, 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 bleep.
He drops a lot of F-bombs and every other word that you can think of.
Corino says, that's real nice, Fred, whatever the heck your name is. Why does Carino's mic sound so much better here than fucking Fred?
Fred's eating his mic, dude.
Yeah,
Fred's
got to
back up 6 inches off the mic, man. Come on, Fred. You do this for a living.
Corino says, all I could hear was 15,000 drunk, and the crowd pops huge. Stoned. They're
that's
losing
me,
it some
that's
more.
Me. He's talking about me.
I'm not done yet.
Their friend says, bleep, 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 bleep.
Hey, crowd, why don't you give them a big bleep, bleep? And they do it.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it. They go, why don't you give this guy one big fuck you, motherfucker? Yeah. And the only reason I know he said it is because I could hear the crowd. They go, fuck you, motherfucker.
This is sick.
And then it cuts to Joey and Joel, and Joey's trying to cut a little gimmick before the next match, and Joel just grabs my and goes, limp biscuits. With a big ass smile.
You do it all for the nookie, the nookie, the nookie, and the nookie does it all for me.
Joe's shaking his head in the back. Yeah.
Limp biscuit.
The big ass smile on his face. And that
little fucking freak.
I realized after watching this, I am Joey Styles when you tried to do the bit at the meetup, and I'm just shaking my head in the back when you're trying to play that sound on the soundboard.
Oh shit! Oh, button number three.
Yeah. And I'm just Joey Styles. Oh my god.
Joel Gerner would have loved that bit.
Yeah, he actually would have really been into it. So we go backstage. Cyrus meets with Jerry Lynn.
Not Jerry Lynn.
We come in and Cyrus is on the phone and he says, yeah, I think we should send him to Memphis. All right, I got to go. Okay.
So there's a big ass bingo sign on the wall behind him. And Jerry Lynn walks in and says, oh, so this really is a bingo.
There's a little sign under that as well. It says, it's just a printed sign, creative department.
Cyrus says, so what's the deal with you and Tajiri? Says, we can't be having the boys book their own angles. It's just bad for business.
You figure it out.
What a nerd.
Cyrus says, Jerry, I'm with the creative department. You can tell me. And Jerry Lynn just looks at him and goes,
No, he doesn't.
No. He just says no and leaves.
Just as simple as no. And then just walks away. Little asshole. All right. Well, now it's time for the main event.
Ooh.
Raven versus Sandman. You're right, man. This is a pretty big match.
Hell yeah. I mean, like, when you think of ECW, I'd say the Mount Rushmore of ECW has Raven and Sandman on it, right?
Yeah,
and Dreamer.
Yeah, Dreamer.
Raven, Sandman, Dreamer, and the fourth unit. You could argue with, you know, Funk or Sabu or...
There's a lot of people that could
RVD,
fit in there, I think.
You know, it's just tough to say. I mean, obviously, Raven, Sandman, and Dreamer have the tenure longer than RVD would, but...
So early on here, I'm not entirely sure how Raven started bleeding.
He was, I don't know. They're fighting on the floor.
He was thrown into a post, I think, right?
That was after he was bleeding, though.
Yeah, Sandman just punched him and he started bleeding. You think he gave him just like a knuckle shot and it just busted him open?
Because they come back from commercial, a table's flipped over and they're just brawling on the floor. So, like, I don't
know. That was the beginning of
there.
The match, actually.
Yeah.
The table was flipped over.
Just table flipped over.
He was bleeding before they even went to that table.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. So it was like really early on.
It must happen. Maybe they had a cut. So I don't know what happened. Maybe just gigged for fun.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Sounds about right.
Yeah. Raven, immediately suplexes Sandman through a table on the outside. That's just the start of the match.
Reverse the suplex, put him like tables propped up on the barricade. Look,
that's
cool.
Their go to commercial spot.
Yeah.
Cool. We come back. Raven does the drop toe hold into the chair on Sandman.
Love it. Vintage Raven.
Sandman goes for a flipping senton into the ring on Raven, who's laying on a table. Raven
which is
moves.
Propped up on a chair.
Yeah, the indie chair thing with the table. Almost with the glass like you would see nowadays.
With a door.
With the table.
Because I think one of the table legs was broken or something. Was, like,
I guess so. Or
so
Sandman was just lazy and didn't want to prop it up. Yeah.
Sandman eats shit on this, by the way. Just goes to the
table. Yeah, like, it looked cool, too, because he flips over the top rope from the apron to do, a senton onto Raven. Raven just sits up, and Sandman eats shit through the table.
My favorite part about it is Sandman eats shit, and then Raven just sits on the broken table, just kind of lays there.
He doesn't give a shit.
I'm already bleeding.
Dude, even... So after that, Dreamer starts doing a double down 10 count. Pretty fucking fast count there, brother. Maybe he slowed down a little.
It was maybe the fastest 10 count ever.
1, 2, 3.
The crowd's going with it, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I could see Dreamer ribbing them, too, by doing that, too, though.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. Raven puts Sandman in a sleeper, and then Sandman does a thing where, he rushes backwards, but, he slams Raven into the broken table, and it looks like it hurts so goddamn much.
Dude, it is the nastiest looking thing ever. Oh, my God.
Just eat shit on the edge of the table.
Gnarly. Like, Raven's like,
fucking shaking his leg. He's like, damn it, that hurts so bad.
Fuck, it looked like it hurt. Jesus.
Raven then hits a low blow on Sandman, then does a headbutt to Sandman's dick.
Yeah, just whatever.
What a little asshole, man.
Yeah.
Then Candido rolls into the ring out of nowhere, and the first thing he does when he rolls into the ring is he low blows Tommy Dreamer.
Oh, well, just before that was Sandman did the cannonball through the table. So there's a table. There's two tables in the ring fucking now, by the way, propped up in opposite corners. Raven's sitting in front of one of the propped up tables, and Sandman just is running cannonball through it.
Cannonballs always look ridiculous.
Yeah,
too.
It looked awesome. And then Candido comes in as Sandman's going for the cover and low blows Dreamer.
Just low blows him, just straight up.
Rhino comes in and gores Dreamer. They're not there to beat up Raven or Sandman. They're just here to beat up Dreamer.
This actually, it's crazy. This whole segment is fucked. I have so many notes just for what happens next. So
post-match.
Yeah, so Candido comes in, low blows Dreamer. Rhino gores him. Yes. Rhino then gores Sandman through a table in the corner.
Through the other table,
yeah. What?
Peaches then comes in the ring and looks at
Lori
both Sandman and Raven. I believe this might be Peach's return to ECW.
I think so, because I think she was gone after that angle. Raven pinned Sandman after that gore, by the way.
That's how they play it up here. They're like, whose side is she on? Whose side is she on?
Oh, right.
They're playing it up, yeah.
Sandman countered the Irish whip, reversed it into the even flow on Raven, then Lori comes out. And she acts like she's going to help Raven up. She helps Raven up, goes down to suck his dick, and low blows him. Damn, Raven, how'd you fall for it? How'd you think she's going to suck your dick here?
So after the low blow, Sandman goes for the cover, but then Francine comes in and attacks Peaches.
What a horrible referee Tommy Dreamer is. Sandman covers Raven. No one breaks up the pin. Dreamer's down there for the count. He gets distracted by Francine and Lori catfighting. I mean, Francine's whole ass was out.
With the tattoo and everything. That's awesome.
Yeah, you're right.
Francine then gives maybe the most stiff DDT I've ever seen to Peaches.
Oh, my God.
That was actually, it's funny because after that, Raven hits the Raven effect.
No, it's the even flow here still, goddammit.
They called it even flow on commentary.
Thank you. It's the damn Francine, even flow.
Francine DDT Peaches and then Raven hit the even flow, but Francine's DDT
Francine's was way stiffer
than the fucking one on Sandman.
I don't know if that's because she didn't know how to give it or Lori didn't know how to take
Lori
it.
Lori did not brace for that
she
at
didn't
all.
Know how to take it at
yeah,
all.
That
yeah.
was rough, man.
And it was cool. So Sandman went to whip Raven. Same way that Sandman got into the DDT with Raven, Raven just did the reverse of that to put Sandman in the DDT. I thought that was cool. Then he goes for the pin, but then here comes the Impact Players to beat up Dreamer.
They just beat up Dreamer on the outside. Oh my
Fucking
God!
Tommy.
Drag him out to whoop his ass. Raven does the armpit dive over the top on the Impact Players. It's pandemonium.
Sandman then goes for a cane hit on Raven as he gets back into the ring. He misses. Raven goes to hit the rope. Justin Credible sitting on the apron, hits him with the cane anyways. Then he turns backwards. Sandman grabs him, hits the White Russian leg sweep, and then Tommy counted the pin. Tommy counted it kind of quick. That's your tag partner here, man. I don't know, man. That's
yeah, well, Raven also is a fucking piece of shit to Tommy still, so I don't know.
That's true.
And then they showed the whole match in a replay, the smallest replay window you could
watch. Wrestling replay by onewrestling.com. Yeah, well, this fucking sucks.
I think you asked
this.
Me that in Chicago, James. I wonder how much they paid for that.
I am wondering if they paid at all.
Really? You think they did it as a rub to get ECW was like, hey, put us more in your magazine?
Yeah, I think they probably said
or
put
them
us
on the website. You know, put us on the website. We'll put you.
Those things were still popular then. The
One Wrestling was huge.
Wrestling.
It was back then. Yeah, it was huge. Yeah, yeah.
Sure.
So after that match, we go to the finale of the Limp Bizkit concert.
So this is so fucking funny because we go back to the concert and it feels as if they were arguing during that whole match.
We come back and they're still arguing. We're not doing any fucking songs.
They were arguing. Yeah. Fred Durst has not performed since. They've just been going back and forth for 20 minutes.
Steve says Fred Durst is what's wrong with the United States of America.
The epitome. Like, what's
damn
wrong with
right.
it?
The crowd cheers.
Damn right.
Yeah.
And Fred Durst says bleep 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 bleep
bleep bleep bleep.
Bleep,
bleep, bleep, bleep. I think Fred at one point said, "You're not hardcore like Balls and Axel and New Jack, motherfucker."
Yeah, he does
Carino,
say that. Yeah.
Axel and Balls and New Jack are on the stage at this point. Axel and Balls are behind them, but New Jack is standing right in front of them, and Steve Carino has to pretend that he's not there.
New Jack is beside Fred Durst. Steve is looking directly at him. Well, thank God they're not here. And then New Jack goes,
here.
Oh shit. You see New Jack run to the other side of the stage.
Fuck. If they were here right now, New Jack is eye to eye with him. I'd kick their ass.
Oh, not to mention that Balls and Eggs are tapping him on the shoulder the entire time he's talking.
That could have been anybody. That could have been the girl from earlier.
Yeah, that's true. I guess there's 40
you see
people
New
on the
Jack
bench.
And two people are tapping you on the shoulder. I wish they were here.
Fuck. If they were here. Oh.
So Axel Rotten finally gets his attention. And he turns around and he hits him. And then he
punches
goes into
him.
Fred Durst. Fred Durst then holds him right up, and then New Jack comes over. Was that a drink that he hit him with?
I think it was a beer,
A full beer. That was $18.
Yeah,
a full beer just right over his head. $19.99. So,
oh, my God.
Yeah,
a lot of money.
Right. God. I feel like I feel like New Jack wasn't even supposed to do anything here. He just did it because Steve was like, they were not positioned
for this.
What
was he
going
to do about it? Yeah, what was he going to do about it? Yeah.
Yeah. New Jack saw him coming over to the concert. He just grabbed a beer and walked with him.
He was like, oh, shit, was that supposed to be over here? So New Jack hits him with the drink and then Balls fucking brains him with a chair.
Same word I wrote, brains him. Yeah.
Yeah, dude, it was rough. Brutal. I was like, oh, wow, that's probably the last chair shot, right? No.
Yeah.
Not right.
It is not. Fred high fives them all too.
Hell yeah, I think Fred was huge in the ECW. I think he was.
There was an
ECW
chant in the crowd too.
New Jack then holds Steve Carino and he's fucking just bleeding. Like he's just holding him by the head and he's just bleeding.
Yeah. Fred says, get his ass off the stage. And he thinks about it. How about one more for the road?
New Jack says, okay.
True.
So he holds his bleeding fucking head. Axel Rotten and hits him again with this
so
fucking
hard.
Oh my God, this chair shot.
Worse than the first one, I feel
like. Yeah, this was
just
rough.
Annihilates him with it. And that's how the show goes off the air with dead Steve Carino.
Fred Durst says, as the screen is going black, he says, all right, this next song is called No Sex.
And excess No Sex as well.
What a great ending to the show. You got Steve Carino fucking bleeding on the ground. And this next song is called No Sex. That's
is
ECW.
It No Sex?
Yeah, it's called No Sex.
Oh, that's right. That is one of the songs. You're right. So what was the Steve Carino match? Because he doesn't get a match the next week either. Well, this was, where did they say this concert was? Maybe we can get to the nitty gritty of this. Peoria?
Peoria is what it is.
Yeah, Indiana?
Illinois.
Illinois. Peoria, Illinois. So let's get to the nitty gritty here. Where
ECW
was Steve,
Peoria.
Where was ECW? When were they in Illinois in 99?
I found, that's 2000. He only wrestled one match in Peoria, and that was in 2000. Maybe he was getting ready for his match in 2000. It was Jerry Lynn and Tommy Dreamer versus Scotty Anton and Steve Carino.
Damn it.
I think that's right, boys. I think we figured it out. All right, and that was ECW for December 3rd.